This is your pre-London outlook for April the 27th, 2009. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Let me remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is non-alert service. Myself and none of the other currency coaches will make any trade recommendations. However, what we will do is conduct some fundamental and technical analysis. I'll help you hopefully put together some good positive trade plans. Please keep in mind trading under leverage is risky, especially as a novice trader. Occasionally this leverage will work for you. Fortunately, more times than not, it's going to work against you. So please do not trade real money until you have a good proven track record of success on a demonstration account. All right, guys. Well, I hope everybody had a good weekend. Interesting little gap down on the market and a lot of currency pairs, but I'll try and make some sense of it. A couple of things here. I'm looking at the euro dollar, and this is a 4-hour chart. And it's very apparent that we are now in retracement mode, right? We made this beautiful move up. Okay, and now we're looking to retrace back to the fibs. And if I just, if you just take a wide-angled view of this, this trend line up top here looks like a pretty reasonable broken trend line. Plus, that's the 4-hour 21. So I'm looking for 31.40-ish as the downside profit target. That's also more or less a 382. I mean, at least the 50% of the entire drop. So is the rise done with? I'm not convinced, but what I'm looking to do now is to trade it down to that 50% retracement and then actually look to long off that area to around 33.40. And if I zoom you out, I'll show you why 33.40 is significant, because of this trend line, okay, at the top here. All right, that's also previous horizontal support. So I think that 33.34 to 33.40 area is going to be significant. So basically, what I'm looking to do is actually wait for a pull. If I just take it to the hourly now, basically what I'm looking to do is wait for a fib pullback of this drop, okay, and then look to short the hourly fib pullback down to a 4-hour fib of the whole move, plus a retest of this broken trend line around this 31.40 area as a target. And then if we show, then if we get 15-minute confirmation that we're heading up, look to long it from this zone, looking for that 33.40 area. Okay, so that's my little, that's my little euro dollar trade plan, guys. That took all of about 2 minutes to explain, and on a 15-minute, how do you trade that? You simply grab a little fib of this drop, pull that up, and then look to trade fib pullback, say to this 32 area, and then trade it down as such. Okay, now let's just take a quick look at the pound yen, because it's at an interesting level here. I think I'd better mention it, seeing that I got a little bit of time left on this video. Swap this to an hourly chart and just zoom in. And basically, folks, we're still in a range on this currency pair. I mean, you don't have to be a rocket scientist to see this. How the bottom is clearly defined, and then all the lower highs that we keep making here. If we are able to break below this 141.25, call it 141.20-ish area, I think that we have significant downside on this currency pair. Okay, so the lower highs are pretty well defined, and the bottom is pretty well defined, and if we can break that, even conservatively 140.70, there's one other thing that definitely needs mentioning. This little trend line coming from top here, if you take a look at the support that it was twice, and then additionally, just to the left here, that is also very much in the mix at this level, folks. Not to mention the, not to mention the horizontal support that has been significant, but also that down sweeping trend line. If that's going to all break, call it 140.70, the pound yen is really going to see significant lows. We might even, we might even head down to test this 132 area over the course of the next couple of days. So definitely look out for that. It would be nice to see the market correlate with it. But, the bottom is, just taking back to the hourly, the bottom is very clearly defined, and look to trade a breakout of that. If it breaks out to the upside, okay, well, fantastic, then we're heading up. But I think just the fact that we keep making these low highs leads you to believe that the downside break is probably the higher percentage play than looking for the upside break. Okay? My name is David Pegler. This has been your pre-London outlook for April the 27th, 2009. Take it easy, buddy. I'll catch up with you tomorrow.